In this lesson, we will be addressing some of the more common uses of the Animator class. For complete documentation on the Animator class, see the documentation linked below. In order to affect transitions between the states of an Animator controller, we need to set the Animator parameters to appropriate values. To do this, we need to use some of the functions of the Animator class. Here we have a scene with a model, Ethan, in it. Ethan has an Animator component and a script called EthanScript attached. The Animator component is using a controller named EthanController. If we open EthanController, we can see that there are four states: idle, walk, run, and jump. Additionally, there are two parameters, a float named speed and a trigger named jump. The controller is set up in such a way that Ethan will transition from idle to walk to run based on the speed parameter. Furthermore, if the jump parameter is triggered while Ethan is running, Ethan will enter a jump state. All of the animations of the Ethan model are controlled by these two parameters, which we will now learn to control with our Ethan script. Inside the Ethan script, we first need to create an animator variable named anim to contain our animator object. We get a reference to this animator object in the start method by typing anim equals getComponentAnimator. For further details on the getComponent function, see the lesson linked below. Our animator controller is set up so that the speed parameter will dictate which moving animation is being played. We can use the player's input to control that behavior. The first thing we will need to do is create a float variable, which we will call move, in the update method. Then, we will set the move variable equal to the vertical input axis by typing input.getAxis, and in parentheses, we will pass the string vertical. Next, we will want to pass the value of the move variable to the speed attribute of the animator controller. This is done with the setFloat function of the animator class. We are using setFloat because speed is a float parameter. If it had been a Boolean parameter, we would use setBool. If it had been a trigger parameter, we would use setTrigger, and so on. For each of these functions, there are multiple ways that they can be called. The most common way is to first pass in the name of the parameter you are setting as a string. Then the next item is the value you wish to set that parameter to. In this instance, we will call the setFloat method of our animator variable by typing anim.setFloat, and then in parentheses, the string speed, and our variable move. Back in Unity, we can run our scene. We can see that if we press the W key or the up arrow, our model now moves. The speed parameter and the movement animation played is now controlled by the player. Passing in a string name for the parameter we wish to set can be inefficient because it means that the animator needs to evaluate the string every time it is called. A faster way of setting parameter values is by using hash IDs. Each string that an animator can use is given a hash ID. This is an integer value that is unique for every different string. We can store this value and then set parameters using this ID instead. To do this, first we will need to store the value. Let's create an integer variable named jumpHash to store the hash ID in. We get the value for our hash variable by calling the static method of the animator class string2hash. Since this method is static, we access it by typing animator.string2hash. In the parentheses, we pass in the string we wish to know the hash ID value of. In order to make our model jump, we will need to set the jump trigger parameter in the animator controller. In our case, we want to make the model jump whenever we press the spacebar. So we will start by typing if input.getKeyDown, and then in the parentheses, we will use keyCode.space. Inside our if statement, we will set the jump trigger parameter using the anim.setTrigger method. Inside the parentheses, we will pass our jump hash variable. Remember that this variable contains the hash ID of our jump parameter. Note that since jump is a trigger, we do not need to also pass in a value. Back in Unity, we can run our scene. Notice that while we are running, we can also press the spacebar to jump. We have now utilized both our float parameter speed and our trigger parameter jump to make our model more dynamic. Occasionally, when writing the logic behind animation, we may want to find out what state the controller is in. Let's say, for example, we want to be able to set the jump trigger only when the model is in the run state. The animator has some functions that we can call to find out what state the controller is currently in. We can do this by creating an animator state info variable, which we will call state info. The animator state info class stores the name, name hash, and various other pieces of information about a state. We will set our state info variable equal to the anim.getCurrentAnimatorStateInfo function. Inside the parentheses, we will pass the index of the layer we want to know more about. Since we are dealing with the base layer, we will pass in a 0. Again, we could compare the current animation state's name with a string, but since it is more efficient to compare hash IDs, let's do that instead. We will start by creating an integer named runStateHash and setting it equal to our animator.stringToHash function. We will pass into the parentheses the string baseLayer.run. We have to include the baseLayer dot part because we can have states of the same name on different layers. Now, we can modify our if statement to also only allow our model to jump if stateInfo.nameHash equals our runStateHash variable.